Wherever you go in the world, you can always find a Big Mac. McDonald's have places in virtually every country in the world. And it's the same good wherever you go, always made to exactly the same recipe. So we could use that idea to compare prices of Big Macs in different countries.
This is called the Big Mac Index, and was first published in The Economist magazine as a way of comparing different currencies to see if they're overvalued or undervalued. If the Big Mac Index shows that a burger is cheaper in Poland than, say, in the USA, this suggests that the Polish currency is undervalued when compared with the US dollar. To understand why this is so, we need to understand one of the most basic laws of economics, sometimes called the law of one price. This law states that we expect an identical good to be sold everywhere for the same price. If it were not so, people would buy the good where it's cheaper, which will increase its price there. They'll sell where it's dear, and in doing so, depress the price there. This process, sometimes called arbitrage, leads over time to the same good being sold everywhere for the same price. The law of one price is easy to test in one country. All we have to do is compare prices of goods. Is the price of fuel the same in different markets? Is the price of a Big Mac the same in different towns? But what if we want to compare prices between, say, Poland and the USA, where different currencies are used? We can still do so by looking at international currency markets, where traders exchange currencies at some rate of exchange depending on the supply and demand for the currency. We can find out, for example, the rate that they're exchanging dollars for Polish zlotys at any one time. Using the law of one price, we would expect a basket of goods in Poland to be the same as the same basket of goods in the USA when converted at the going exchange rate. Suppose that goods are generally cheaper in Poland. We would expect people to be keen to buy goods from Poland. Cheaper prices in Poland should cause people to buy Polish currency in order to buy their goods. The increase in demand for zlotys will cause the value of the currency to rise until average prices of goods are the same in each country when converted at the new exchange rate. The Big Mac Index gives us a neat way to see if prices in one country are higher or lower than another country and whether a country's currency is in equilibrium. We use the Big Mac as being representative of a whole basket of goods. Of course, we wouldn't expect people to fly to Poland just because they can get a Big Mac more cheaply. But assuming the Big Mac is typical of prices generally in the two countries, we would expect currency prices over time to adjust if the prices of goods are different. How do we measure the extent to which a currency is undervalued or indeed overvalued against the US dollar according to the Big Mac Index? We can do so by our understanding of percentages. Armed with an understanding of percentages, we can work out the implied undervaluation or overvaluation of a currency. Remember, this is for any one moment of time. Over time, prices and currency values will change. Now, if we know the price of the Big Mac in a country and the current exchange rate, it's easy to work out the implied purchasing power parity, or PPP, of the dollar. We divide column 1 in the table by the US Big Mac price. So taking Germany as an example, if we divide 2.71 euros, the price of the Big Mac in Germany, by $2.71, the price of the Big Mac in the US, then the implied purchasing power parity is 2.71 over 2.71, which is 1. Now, we've done the same for the British pound and the Polish zloty in the table and shown their respective purchasing power parities. Now, what's the meaning of purchasing power parity? This needs care. PPP says you would expect $1 to buy the same amount of goods in the US as 1 euro buys in Germany, and as 2.32 zlotys buys in Poland. We can argue that this is the correct rate of exchange. But the actual rate of exchange is different in each case, as you can see from the table. But we can work out now the under or overvaluation of a currency by comparing the implied rate that we got from the Big Mac with the actual rate. So let's look at the euro and ask whether at this particular moment in time it was under or overvalued according to the Big Mac index. We'll take the difference between the implied rate and the actual rate, but we need to express that as a proportion of the actual rate. It's not the absolute difference that we're interested in, it's the proportional difference. So the under or overvaluation is column 3 minus column 2 over column 2, and then multiplied by 100. So let's see that for Germany. We've got 1.0 minus 1.1, and take that difference and express it as a proportion of 1.1. So we've got 1.0 minus 1.1 divided by 1.1. Now we multiply that by 100, and we get minus 9. What's that minus 9 tell us? It tells us that according to the Big Mac index at this moment in time, the euro is 9% undervalued against the US dollar. According to our table, all three currencies that we're looking at were undervalued against the dollar at that time, but to differing extents. Alternatively expressed, the US dollar was overvalued against these currencies, and we might expect, therefore, that in the long run, if the Big Mac index is useful, the US dollar will tend to fall in value. So when we want to know the significance of the difference between two numbers, it's helpful to express that difference as a percentage. We take the difference between the two values and express that difference as a proportion of the original value, and then multiply it by 100. But notice that for the Big Mac index, we've only worked this out for one moment of time, and you might be interested to look up more recent examples of the Big Mac index and do these calculations for yourself.